Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. We're joining the International Space Station Flight Control Team in the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Mission Control Center in Houston, where the Orbit 2 team is on console at this time, led today again by Flight Director Paul Vai, with Anna Fisher in the CAPCOM seat. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 30 crew is more than halfway through their day, which began at midnight Central Time. U.S. Commander Dan Burbank, as well as Russian flight engineers Anton Shkperlov and Anatoly Ivanishin, are currently orbiting 241 miles above the Pacific Ocean, heading towards the coast of Chile. Burbank, Shkperlov, and Ivanishin launched to the station in their Russian Soyuz TMA-22 vehicle on November 13th and docked to the space station on November 15th, so they're working on their 23rd day in space and their 21st day at the space station. They've been alone at the station since the Expedition 29 crew members left on November 21st, but they'll soon be joined by the remainder of the Expedition 30 crew. Flight engineers Don Pettit, Oleg Kononenko, and Andrei Kuipers are currently at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, Russia, near Moscow. And they've been conducting some administrative work there today and will be moving on Thursday to the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, where their Soyuz TMA-03M is being prepared for the December 21st launch to the space station. Pettit, Kuipers, and Kononenko are scheduled to reach the space station and join Burbank, Shkperlov, and Ivanishin on December 23rd. But while they wait for their crewmates' arrivals, the astronauts currently on board the station are staying busy. They're still learning life in the space station, so some time is set aside each day for the crew members to spend an hour or so to explore the station and learn its systems. Today, all three crew members came together for a depressurization drill to practice the procedures they'd go through if the station had a leak. And Burbank is also working on an integrated cardiovascular experiment that looks at how the body's cardiovascular system reacts to being in space and getting ready for the installation on Thursday of the Amin swing bed prototype, which will be tested for use in the future Orion vehicle for removing carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. That's what's going on in space today, and this is Mission Control Houston.